Hi, today I want to look at some different ways to color canvas. This particular canvas I think is from Prima. I'm not sure this particular product is still available, but there are lots of canvas items out there, mistable items, and of course you can mist it, but there are lots of other ways to color these as well. Let me show you a layout that I've been working on. These flowers, I cut them out and I roughed up the edges a little bit, and these two were misted. This was misted with a Studio Calico Mr. Huey mist. This one was misted with a homemade mist where I just took some dye ink and mixed it with water and misted it that way. I got a little bit splotchier kind of look. And then this one, I just took the flower and I rubbed it on the top of the ink pad. So I took a dye ink pad and then I just rubbed this along the top and it transferred the color over. So that was how I colored the three flowers, and then I went back over each one of them and stamped them with a slightly darker color stamp over the top to create the flowers. And that was all I did for those. Let's look at a few other ways to color these. Of course you can mist them. Another way that you can color things is to use markers. So I'm going to create this type of look using these markers. And these are water-based markers, and it is important to use water-based for this technique. These happen to be stamping up markers, but it could be really any water-based marker that you wanted to use. I haven't tried the Ranger Distress markers, but I think they would work really well since they're water-based. And I'm not being fancy, of course, with my coloring. Just adding a little color as we go around. This kind of gives a little bit of that ombre look that's so popular. I'm working from dark to light. And I don't have to get every bit of it colored. And if anything ends up being missing, I can always add a little more color to them. That's one of the nice things about this canvas is you can layer. You can mist one color on, you can add another layer, you can stamp over the top. You can just keep adding layers. Of course, if you're using water-based items, the colors may run together. And that's exactly what I'm looking for in this technique. Okay. All right. Fancy coloring job. I'm going to bring my box over. And I'm ready to mist. I'm just going to mist with plain water. Go over it good with plain water and then spread the ink around. I'm using my finger to spread the ink around a little bit. If I need to, I can add a little more water. And there's the same technique. Now for this one, I got a little bit more red on this one and I wanted to do a little more yellow, so I didn't spread the ink quite as far to the edges as I had on that previous flower. But I'll let that dry and then we'll do some other things with this. Well, now I think my large flowers have dried. So I'm ready to add some additional interest to them, and I'm going to use some swirly stamps. These are an older set from Scrappy Cat. I have some flourishes from Autumn Leaves. Anywhere that you get, you know, these kinds of these sort of all over images like flourishes, dots, whatever, any kind of geometric image, they'll work really well. Alright, I'm going to stamp my image in a little bit darker ink than the flower so it will show up. So I'm using some Riding Hood Red ink from Stamping Up. I'm not going to apply any more mist or anything to these flowers, so I can use a dye ink. If I were going to mist them some more, I would need to use a permanent ink. This may not actually be dark enough. Let's see how it comes out. There we go, give it a little bit more pressure. Yeah, that's coming out better. Okay. That adds a bit more interest to the flower. Oh, it's really showing up on this one that I stamped lighter. So a couple of different versions with the same technique, just depending on how much I spread the darker colored inks out and how dark the stamping came out. So you get a little bit different effect with these. And I'll show you then the projects that I completed using these canvas flowers. Another way to treat canvas is you can dye it with some dye ink and water, and you can do some shaping. For this particular flower, these two flowers, these were started out as larger versions of this. I think the largest one was actually this flower that I cut out, and then this one was the size that was in between these two. And I wanted them, this was just too big for me, so I needed to bring it in a little bit for what I had in mind. So I started by, I did a little bit of misting so I could shape the flower, and then I decided to just dye it. So I took a cup of, a plain cup, and put some water and a few drops of ink, of dye inks, and I think for this one I was using an orange colored ink, even though it kind of came out pink, and for this one I was using burgundy ink, and it actually also came out more of a reddish color. So you have to do a much darker colored ink than what you want in the end. And you can always experiment, especially if you have something like this where you're going to be cutting them out. You've got some scrap canvas you can play with and see what colors things are going to come out. But once I dyed them, they were nice and wet. Then I took them and I sort of squished them up with my fingers. And while they were wet, I clipped them with the clothespin and just let them dry that way. And I did the same thing with a small one, and I clipped it with the clothespin, and I just let them dry that way so that when I took them apart, then I have two flowers that I can stack together, and they're not nearly as large as this really big flower started out, and they have some more dimension to them. The only thing I kind of wish I had done was stamped something on them before I started misting them together. If you're going to do your stamping first, you do need to do stays-on or some type of permanent ink. Otherwise, when you mist, it's going to run. Unless you want that look, I should have stamped in a black or brown or whatever color stays-on I have a nice design on there before I put these together. But these will still be pretty, even without the stamping. And I have a brad here that I will probably use in the middle of these. So that can still make a really pretty flower. And I also roughed up the edges because I think these particular ones look prettier with the edges roughed up. Okay, I'm going to dye this little flower like I did this one, except I'm not going to squinch it up. So I'm just going to rough up the edges a little bit. And I'm going to drop it into my mixture of Bravo Burgundy ink and water. It's probably going to come out a little dark, and I want to show you how I handle that. Okay. Like that. hook around there. And somewhere I have a set of tweezers. They're a good idea, so you don't have to get your hands quite as inky as mine are getting. I think I took them downstairs the other day, and they haven't made their way back to my workroom, or my craft space. If you get too much dye, you can just take a lot of it off with a paper towel. Now, I've probably taken off more than I wanted, so I'm going to drop it back down in there for another coat. Okay, that's not bad. I think actually that'll be a pretty good color. So I'm just going to let that lay on the paper towel and dry. So that's just a simple way to add color, is to mix a few drops of ink into some water, and then you can create a nice dye.